talk about other kinds of speech rooms first. So this kitchen is a mess. Now, if somebody could simply say that as a descriptive statement, you know, you could just, you know, say, I'm just an objective person making an objective observation. But it's not just an objective observation. It's always, you know, understood in a context, in a wider context, as possibly a complaint, right? And complaining is another kind of speech act, right? Or you look so nice today, right? It's not just an objective statement. It's intended as a compliment, right? I'm hungry for Thai food could be understood as either a suggestion or a request. That's not how you say it. I'm hungry for Thai. How are you? Notice how are you is actually a question, right? But it's often understood as a greeting. I know nothing about the $2 million stolen from the bank yesterday. That's a denial. I'm the person doing it for, right? Bragging or admitting. So all of these sort of minor league speech acts are examples of illocutionary verbs, verbs that do something by saying something. Can you guys think of others? We've made kind of a list here. Right, complimenting. What makes these verbs interesting is that they all have to do with ways of speaking, right? You can't say that somebody is participating in the activity of these verbs without actually speaking. And so we have this huge number of verbs in English that all modify or say something about the way in which speech happens or say something about the intended effect of a speech act. Okay? What else? Brag, admit, suggest.
Not remind.
Just want to make sure, are all those words belong to the minor league?
Ah, okay. Yeah. And we have many, 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 many more in English language. And you probably have never even thought about the fact that we have this many in English. But I became acutely aware of it when I started studying Ecuadorian Quechua with a serious purpose, you know. And people in Quechua speaking society have about 5 speech act verbs total. They have to say, they have to speak, they have to question, they have to criticize. Yeah, actually 4 that I can think of right now. So how do they express all these nuances, do you think? And many, many more. I once counted about 80 speech act verbs in English. These verbs are maybe part of the English language for a really long time. Who are the English language specialists in the house? Who are the e-learners? Malin? No? Everyone else is language? Okay. Do you know anything about when these entered the English language? They've been around for a long time. I know they're part of early modern English.
About 1,000 years
since the French before they started adding more words to English. Yeah, about 1,000 years. So, what other ones can you think of? We're talking minor league. Yeah, Nala?
Can miss feel like I miss you? Could that be an expression? Or is that
kind of an expression of what I'm feeling?
Yes.
Like, I'm missing, but just like, I don't know, I'm just wondering about that.
Yeah, because just could say, oh, it's been so long since I've seen you, like you're describing.
Yes.
I thought I missed you.
Yeah, I would be happy to include that here. I think you can say I miss you and you're telling, you're at the same time performing the act of feeling sad about that person's lack of presence. Yeah. Yeah. So what else?
So that you could put also thank, right? When the
absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah. What else?
Choose.
Choose doesn't necessarily have to be accompanied by action.
Sometimes it
works. But I choose, you can, it could be illocutionary. But if you think of choose as simply to select, like which one is she going to select, this one or that one? You can do it by picking something up, right?
Yeah.
Would apologize count as major?
That's a good one, yeah. Would it count as major
or minor? I just feel like, because I mean, like, it seems more, I guess the way you phrase it depends on how formal it comes across.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I would consider that it,
you don't have to have authority to do it. Okay.
Yeah.
What about suggest?
Oh, suggest is a great one. Is it?
Advise.
Advise is a good one.
Sorry.
Encourage. I wish you a Merry Christmas. How about forgive? Protection, I think, is more physical in action.
I agree with that.
Yeah. Okay. So you get the sense, you get the idea here that you can use language in many ways, and all of these verbs specify certain aspects of the way in which you're using language. So how do you think Quechua people would communicate similar kinds of meanings? Adverbs? I like that answer because I think adverbs are seriously underappreciated by most people. But that's not the way they typically do it. They actually do it by, yeah, Kate?
I think maybe like hand, like by gesture or tone or something that they do with their body. So
it definitely has to do with gesture and intonation. That's a part of it, yeah. Any other ideas?
Yeah. Use the ways that are four.
There are about four verbs, yeah.
Could like use those to say it in a roundabout way. Like I say, instead of like I compliment, they can say like I say you look nice.
Yeah. Like, saying you look nice. That's what they do. They do speech reports. And actually, I stand corrected. They do sometimes use adverbs, but there's only a limited number of adverbs that modify the way people speak. But they can say, for example, if somebody criticized, they would say saying. You're not a good hunter, he said angrily, right? And then you know, the context would tell you that person was angry, or you could use some kind of an adverb for, you know, pinyasha is an adverb for to be angry at somebody. But so they do a lot of speech reporting. They tell people the words that were said, and then it's your job to infer what the illocutionary force of that speech report is supposed to be. Yeah. So you would think it would be a very cumbersome system. We have all these nice verbs that we can use instead. But the thing is, when you use these verbs, a lot of times you gloss over some of the subtlety. And so Quechua people actually bring quite a bit more subtlety to the table sometimes when they quote people, because they do not want to ascribe intentions to people that people themselves don't have. So they're very, very careful about representing other people's perspectives, which is why they like to report speech instead of saying, you know, somebody suggested, somebody complimented, somebody complained, somebody criticized. They'll just tell you what they said and let you draw the conclusions about their overall, you know, point of view. So So it's kind of a cool thing about their culture is that they really want to be careful about not overgeneralizing and overrepresenting people and making claims that, that are not warranted. Let's look at, the book has a few. Okay, you should understand terms from this unit. Speech act, active referring, active insert, active assertion, descriptive fallacy, performative utterance, blah, blah, blah. Okay, we did that. So I'm looking at page 267, and they've got a list of sentences, not a very long one, but I want to read out a few of these to you and see if you can come up with some kind of illocutionary verb that would capture what the sentence is meaning is. Okay. Sentence A is, the car is dirty. Could be a complaint. What else might it be?
Suggestion.
Could be a suggestion, yeah. Right. How about some of the pages have been torn out? Could be what?
Confession.
A confession. It could be.
Justifying. In the case where it's like, I'm trying to sell this, but some of the papers are.
Yeah. Or I didn't get that question on the test right because the book I was studying from had some of the pages torn out. Justification. Yeah. An accusation. Yeah.
An apology.
Yeah. What about, decide whether these utterances are performative or constitutive. Remember, we said constitutive were the ones that are just making an observation about the world. I order you to pay the bill. Performative. I pronounce you man and wife. Performative. I promise to drop by tomorrow.
Performative.
Okay. The minister pronounced them man and wife. Constitutive, right? I promised to drop by tomorrow. Constitutive. I sweep the floor every Tuesday.
Constitutive.
I believe you were wrong. Constitutive. Right. Okay. Identify which of the following. Well, I don't know if we have time for that. Okay. Yeah. Let's skip that. Any other questions or comments or? Okay. So on Friday. One of my daughters has an athletic injury that she has to have surgery for, and I'm not sure if she's, I don't know what time the surgery is, they never tell you till the day before. But it's highly unlikely that I'll be able to be here on Friday. So, luckily we have wonderful Tracy who's going to take the helm and teach our next unit.
Yay!
Yay! And so, we get a different voice for a change. He's also going to hand out assignment 6, okay? Which he already has a copy of. Oh, I should print those out, shouldn't
I? I can do it.
Can you put it on not at your expense?
Not that I know of.
Okay.
I have been using it for the last 2 semesters.
Awesome. All right. Thank you very much. Bye, Charlie.
Okay,
you already turned it off?
No.